They coming with records like that.
It's just a public service announcement.
Thing ain't lie, I done came through the block and everything that's fly. I'm like, stop it, nigga.
Sponsored by Just Blaze and the good folks at Rockefeller Records.
Nigga, stop it.
Fellow Americans, it is with the utmost pride and sincerity that I present this recording as a living testament and
recollection. We had two studios, we had Baseline, and we had Battery Studios, which was around the corner. Black Album was done, it was handed in. My two contributions were December 4th and the intro, which I was fine with. And we're at Battery mixing something. One of my best friends by the name Big Jack comes in the studio. Y'all got something you gotta hear. Put the headphones on, he puts this record on, and all you heard was dun, 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 dun. And I'm just sitting there like, what is about to happen? The engineer freaks out, he turns around and he's like, yo, what's going on? And I'm like, nothing, keep doing what you're doing. So I made the PSA beat in the headphones while the engineer was mixing whatever record we were working on. I made the beat in like 10 minutes. And I ran over to the studio, and Jay had up around the corner back to Baseline, and Jay had left already. So the next day, Jay's doing listening sessions for the press, for the Black Album. Like he had like all the Viacom people there, then he had all the hip hop magazines like Source and XXL there. It was like different rounds of listening sessions for different people. So when he gets there to start his press run for the day, I'm like, nah, you gotta come in here. And I play it, and at first his reaction was just like, and I'm like, did you not hear what we're all hearing? Changed the artwork, stopped making the CDs. And then he went and started doing press. In between rounds of press, he would come in, drop 4 bars, go do another press round. Come back in, drop 4 more bars, go do a press round. Come back in, change, scrap the first 8 bars he did, give a whole new 8 bars, and add 4 more bars, and go do another press round. Which means as he's doing the press, he's thinking about this beat in the back of his mind and coming up with the song. In between press runs, he lays it all. By the end of the night, he's like, all right, let me hear it. And then he's like, nah, and he walks out. So he comes in the next day, spits the whole thing over in one take, and it was like, add that to the album, take Looking at My S-Dots on. So yeah, scrap Looking at My S-Dots, put that on, and then two or three weeks later, we're at the Garden. And the entire arena knows the words.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is O-O-H to the O-V. I used to move snowflakes by the O-Z. I guess even back then you could call me C-O or the R-O-C.
There's so many coincidences. I kind of tend to feel like it was something that was supposed to happen because that song was supposed to find its way out to the world.